I am the Edison phonograph. The more you become acquainted with me, the better you will like me. Ask the dealer.
Hey everybody, welcome back to Record-ology. Look what just arrived from Canada. This is an Electrohome signature vinyl record player. So let's go ahead and see what we got here. I'm going to be careful not to damage it here with my box cutter. Oh, I just love it when you open the outer box and there's like an even shinier inner box on the inside. Alright guys, check that out. The Electrohome signature system. Beautiful. Now they even have like artwork all over the box. I mean, that just, talk about high quality. That just looks amazing. Absolutely beautiful. Look at this. Backed by over 100 years of manufacturing high quality audio products, Electrohome has paired the design of their vintage record players with the technology of modern music systems. This promises to be a very amazing system. So I'm very excited to see what we got here exactly. And should be really fun. This company was founded in 1907 and was the biggest Canadian manufacturer of television sets for a long time. And even made the CRT monitors that NASA used. And a lot of other cool things. High quality packaging right up front, can tell you that. Very unique packaging. So we've got our owner's manual there. Is that a remote control? That's cool. I think there's a remote control. That's awesome. All right. This is always the hardest part, how to get it out of the box. Silica packet, lest there be no moisture inside. And I've got it completely upside down. I'm going to rotate this. Alright. It is heavy. It is much heavier than other vintage vinyl record players. Oh, look at that. Isn't that beautiful? Look at the finish on that. Oh, effortless lift on the kickstand there. I mean, just effortless. It just, right. On the inside, we've got some sort of spacer there. Oh, I love it when they put the instructions like this. Check that out. Quick start guide, how to get started. All right, some observations here, and very well packaged. I mean, I can tell you already the quality on this thing is very high. They even have spacers underneath the platter so that it doesn't get damaged in transit. You got the typical locking screw. We'll put that down once we get it all in the house here. The tone arm and the tone arm assembly, I can tell you right now, is super high quality. It's not the typical typical one that's used by a lot of the other companies, which is very similar. They are very similar to each other. This one is very different, but very high quality, and it looks like it's going to be really fun. Very unique design, and excited to give it a test drive and see how it sounds. Okay guys, so we got the unit unpacked and up here in the music room, and as I always do, I'm starting with the back panel. As you notice, this gorgeous finish, walnut finish, extends to the back, which is important to me. Shows a sign of quality that the manufacturer, the designers, thought to include finishing touches all the way to the back, which isn't often seen, but I think makes a big difference. There's a typical power cord here wrapped up. So yeah, very, very nice. Still have the notch up here for the larger records to extend into. High quality hinges. The stain is just amazing. It's a very deep walnut colored stain, very rich. We have the typical vents back here. FM antenna, which you just let it hang over the back. And kind of interesting, the auxiliary input is in the back, which is cool. Nothing wrong with that. But yeah, it looks like it's a solid unit. I love the curved edges of this thing. Very unique design. All right, guys, here is the front panel of this bad boy. Boy, does it look gorgeous and very unique. It's very different than a lot of the retro entertainment centers that are out there. It looks like these little protective tapes that come off. Oh, it protects the CD drawer. Really cool. And you know, the front panel of this thing with these knobs and the way this goes laterally like that, it really reminds me of like a mid-century 50s, 60s, like Buick, you know, car radio. It's really cool design. On the left here, you've got your volume control. On the right, you've got your tuning adjustment. Looks like a macro adjustment, then a fine tuning adjustment, maybe. USB, which is gonna show, we'll show that some really cool stuff there. Power switch, record. Yes, record, you heard that right. Function switch. Over here, we've got your transport controls and some other adjustments as well, including play, pause, and open for the CD drawer. Down here, we've got some push-button controls for AM, FM, CD, aux, phono, just really cool and unique. It's not, you know, it's different than what you usually see. So that's really cool to see a very unique design. All right, guys, looking at the top here. So I love when you lift this and it just, you don't even have to go quick about it like some of the other ones. I mean, this, literally this mechanism here is actually sunken down below the baseboard there. And when you want to drop it, you just pull back on it and rest it down. And this is so beautiful. This, the furniture aspect of this is just amazing. I mean, the quality, and it smells like a furniture showroom in here. It's just beautiful. And then this finger notch to lift it, and then the kickstand there just automatically goes in position. All right, as with all record players, we need to tighten that down so we can get her locked and loaded. All right, the transit screw is down. We need to make sure that the tone arm lock is in place. It actually shipped with the lock out of place, so the tone arm was resting where it shouldn't be, which is okay, that happens. But thankfully, due to this little protector right here, nothing was damaged. So we're going to pull that off so the stylus is okay, put the lock mechanism back in. This also has the gentle raise and lower mechanism. Let's get a little better look at how that works exactly. Okay, so here is the tone arm lift and lower mechanism. I know it's a little dark there, but basically once the lock is taken off, use this little lever here to raise it, and then you can rotate the tone arm over onto the platter, over the record, and then pull the switch down. I'm not gonna do it now because I don't have a record on. And then that will gently lower the stylus onto the record, which will protect your vinyl or other records. And then you just flip the switch right there and it just gently lowers. Very cool. Also, the speed selector switch is right there as well. All right, guys, to start off with, let's test the record player out. You know, given the mid-century vibe of this awesome machine, I thought we'd listen to some mid-century music. So I'm gonna put on some Elvis. I'm gonna go ahead and set it down here. One thing I can tell you is there's a lot more room. This is a bigger device, if you could see it side by side compared to some of the competition out there. Definitely a bigger unit. Which is cool, I like it. I mean, that's part of what makes it awesome. So, our selector switch is set to 33. We're going to raise, we're gonna unlock the tone arm. Then we're gonna raise the stylus. We're gonna rotate it out over the start of the record. And you'll notice that the record starts playing automatically. And we're going to flip this lever in the back and the tone arm will automatically lower. So let's see what we got. One thing that is unique about these Electrohome units is the speaker grill in the front. There are multiple speakers. There's actually four speakers rather than the customary two, so you get more of a full range sound. Initially, the sound is very bright. It is very crystal clear. And I do hear bass. I hear a good amount of bass, but this isn't really a bass recording, so we'll test out the bass aspect of it with something else. But, you know, just, you know, really good sound. I really love it. It's got a great design. It's like the perfect combination of quality sound and styling as well. Just super cool. Okay, guys, I want you to see something. This is super, super cool. And before we get to the very end of the record, I want to make a note. All record players are going to sound a little bit more tinny when the volume is down. When I turn the volume up, it becomes exponentially more full the louder it gets, and that's typical. So I'm going to turn down the volume a little bit so you can hear me. But this record player has an amazing feature that none of its competition can match. And I want you to witness it in real time right here as we come to the end of the record. It is very typical for record players of this type to have an auto stop. So when you hit the run out groove, the record will automatically stop and the tone arm will just rest there in the run out groove until you lift it. And that protects the vinyl, protects the needle, make sure that you don't hit the paper label with the needle or stylus. But you have to lift it back into the rest or into the cradle of the tone arm rest itself. This one, however, has a little bit unique way to handle things, and for this record player to have this feature at this price, I am very, very surprised. So here we go. We're hitting the runout groove, and let's watch what happens. Very impressed. I think this is a great feature and something that I'm going to really enjoy, and I bet you will as well. So we've finished the record and we've hit the runout groove. Let's see what happens. Look at that. That, my friends, is an auto return. And it auto returns all the way back into the rest and drops it. That is phenomenal. Very impressive. All right, guys, next up, let's try a 78. I haven't tested one of these in one of these review videos with a 78 before. Now, keep in mind that in order to properly play a 78, you really need to have a 3mm stylus. This is going to have a 1mm or micro groove stylus because the grooves on an LP or a 45 are much smaller than those of a 78, which has a wider groove. That's why this entire 10-inch record only has about 3 minutes worth of music, 3.5 minutes worth of music. So the sound that you get by playing a smaller stylus in a larger groove is typically a little bit more tinny, a little bit less full and rich than you would get with a proper stylus. But let's see how it sounds anyway. Still should be enjoyable. Look at how fast that tone arm is tracking across that record. You know, this sounds better to me. The 78 on this player sounds better than on the competition, in my opinion, from what I've heard so far. It sounds like it's tuned in such a way that the it really maximizes even that larger groove. You know, I expect the 45s and the LPs to sound good, but this record sounds excellent. This is a mid to late 40s reissue of a Glenn Miller record. That's it's a dub, but it's still very, very cool to hear this. And it sounds good, very rich, very full. You hear surface noise, but you're going to hear surface noise on a 78. Yeah, very cool. I would say this is beyond acceptable. This is very good sound for a 78. All right, guys, now we're going to do the 45 stop test. So, as we've talked about before, some of these players have a hard time getting to the inside edge of a 45 RPM record without the auto reject, auto stop, or in this case, auto return mechanism kicking in. So let's go ahead and see what happens. I've queued this up near the end of this 45. Let's go ahead and drop the needle and see what we get. So we got an Elvis record playing here. Let's see if it makes it to the end or if it stops prematurely. That's the big test. We're getting close here. Will it make it to the end without auto-rejecting or auto-returning? Should hit the run-out groove and then return. Okay, it hit the end and it returned. I'm gonna say that was a success. You did hear the last groove repeat a couple of times. Let's go ahead and try another record and see if that's just this record or if it did reject a little too soon. Okay, so similar to the other record, this is an EP, so these are even more difficult for players to manage because they have a little more data crammed in there, a little closer to the groove. It looks like it made it to the final groove, and then it sensed that run-out groove lead-in, and then it rejected. So it did reject a tad bit prematurely, but you did get to the end of the song there. So something interesting to note, still acceptable performance from my perspective.
Now we're going to listen to the CD player. The opening closes on the far right there. It's a very thin CD drawer. So we're going to put some Frank Sinatra in there and give it a listen here. Plays right here. Let's see how it sounds.
Fairy tales can come true.
It's a very rich, very warm tone. It is excellent, excellent sound quality. You really get the sense that this unit was designed not only with styling in mind, but with sound quality in mind. Very full range, very rich bass, very responsive and high, very bright, high end. Okay, let's go ahead and give the radio a demo. So we're going to switch to FM. The tuning knob has a macro adjustment and a fine tuning adjustment on the inside, which is really, really nice. I played with this a lot last night and I noticed that the stations come in very clear. It's got this beautiful amber light when you're on the radio setting, I think on AM as well. Yeah, so if you go to AM radio, it'll pull that up with the same amber light, which is really nice at night. It's a really, really, really cool feature. Now, if you want to, you can hit the auxiliary, and I'm not going to test that, but that is available to you if you want to connect a device as well. Phono, obviously, is the record player. So you've got AM, FM, CD/USB, auxiliary in, and phono. All right, next thing we're going to test is, I think, the most exciting feature about this unit, and that is its ability to record from either CD or record onto a USB. So, if you get yourself a thumb drive like this or any other, I don't know if you can do this directly to a USB device like a phone or if it has to be like a thumb drive. So basically, you just stick your thumb drive in right there. Now you'll notice this record feature right here. The way you start a recording is double tapping the record. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this to CD. I'm going to start playing a CD song, and we're going to record from CD to begin with and see how that works. Okay, so the CD is playing, and we're going to hit record. And you will notice it now says record on the display there. And the USB is flashing, indicating it is recording. To stop the recording, I just hit stop. You will notice that the USB is still writing data. It's probably closing out that recording. And what we are going to do now, since we are on the CD USB input at the bottom there, we are going to try and play from that. So, we're going to press function until it reads USB, and now it is playing off of the USB drive. Track number one. Folder number one, track number one. Fairy, and that is recorded right from our CD. Very cool. Okay, now let's try recording from a record. Okay, now that we've got our USB inserted, we've got our record on the turntable and our stylus positioned over the beginning of the record, all you have to do is double click the record button and you will see the USB light flash. That depends on whether or not your USB drive actually has a light, but then lower the stylus and the recording will begin.
I just bought me a great long ticket. I'm gonna use it at 4 p.m. Texas bound.
Okay, now something else to note that is important is that no matter where your volume control is, that does not impact the recording volume. That's preset. So it is a line level input onto the USB. So you don't need to worry about the volume positioning while you're recording. When you're done with the recording, you just hit stop down here. And you will see that flash again to close out the file, and you can then bring the stylus back. Or if it's at the end of the record, it'll auto-return. Okay, and when you're ready to play back your recording from the record, you simply press CD USB down here, and then you press the function button right here, which will change it from CD to USB, and then it'll automatically start playing off of the thumb drive or the USB drive. And then you can skip forward to listen to your different recordings. Now here is our Merle Travis. There's a little bit of silence because of the time it took from when we hit record to when the stylus dropped. And there it is.
I just bought me a great long ticket. I'm going to use it at 4 p.m. So you can.
And it'll show you the folder and the track number on the display there. I want to point out what an incredible feature this is right here. You can record and encode MP3 files from CD or record without the use of a computer. The only downside, and it's not really a downside, is you have to do it in real time. So you can't, you know, like when you rip a CD on a computer, that's faster, obviously. So you have to do it in real time. But for records, this takes away the need for a USB turntable completely, which is an amazing, amazing feature. Again, for the price of this unit, it gives you some incredible features, and the ability to record MP3 files is just phenomenal. I think that's an amazing, amazing feature. Record MP3 files, and you can load up a thumb drive with MP3 songs and play them as a source, not just as a recording and playing back. Okay, everybody, so here is some packaging that came with it. We've got a user manual in French and in English, which is in color. At least the front thing is, which is really cool. There's a lot of details here, obviously, as you would expect. A lot of useful information. A couple interesting things to note. The cartridge is actually replaceable on this unit, not only the stylus. So you can replace the cartridge. I'm not sure if you have to use a similar type cartridge or if you can use a Shure cartridge or something like that. But pretty interesting. Also comes with a remote control, which is really cool. Let's open that up. Pull that out there. And there's a little battery protect. So we pull that out. And as you can see, it says Electrohome. And that gives us your basic transport controls, record capability, eject capability for the CD, random program, and delete as well. So it's kind of handy to have this little remote, so you can control some of the functions with the remote. I don't think that detracts from the cool vintage nature of this unit. I think that it adds to it. It adds capability. So yeah, really cool. All right, everybody, that completes our review of the Electrohome Signature Vinyl Record Player. You know, I think this is a great unit. I think the styling is second to none. I really like the mid-century theme. Most of these vintage systems go for the earlier Victrola phonograph era look, which is cool, and I do love that as well. But it's pretty unique for a system to go for a mid-century sort of 50s, 60s look to it, which I think is really cool. I really like the styling of the front panel. I love the radio control. I like the radio, how it's designed in such a way that it almost looks like the stereo out of a, you know, a 50s or 60s era Buick. Or Chevrolet or something. Very cool design. Sound quality is good. The record player sound quality is very good. The transport control, the record player sound quality is good. the ability to have an auto return on a record player is a phenomenal function. It's pretty much a automatic turntable. The only thing you manually need to adjust is the position. The only thing you need to manually adjust is the initial position of the stylus. But once you drop the tone arm with the gentle release mechanism, it is fully automatic at that point, which is very, very cool. The CD player on this is phenomenal. The sound quality is absolutely amazing. Very rich, very full. This unit does not have a tape player, which I actually wish it did. I think that would definitely add to it, but it's not an incredible loss. Considering the other functionality that was added to it, I think that it's an acceptable thing to not have the tape player on it, but I do wish it did have the tape player. The CD and record record to USB functionality is phenomenal. The ability to record onto USB to create MP3 files from a record especially, and from a CD without the use of a computer, is an absolutely astonishing feature that really sets this unit apart. So not only great styling, great sound, but added functionality with the USB. I think that's very, very, very cool. And you can plug in any device with the auxiliary input on the back. So the cost of this unit is approximately $200 US, a little bit less than that. So price-wise, it's a bit higher than the competition in terms of a lot of the other vintage players. However, I think that the quality is higher. I think that the transport mechanism on the record player is especially higher. The fact that you can replace the cartridge and that it seems to have a very high quality record player definitely sets this apart. The ability to have the MP3 encoding USB functionality is just amazing and definitely worth it for the price. So, there you go. I hope you enjoyed this review. If you did enjoy it, please subscribe to Record-ology, check out more reviews, and all cool things that have to do with records and retro tech. Alright guys, thanks for watching as always. Happy record hunting. We'll see you next time.